Alina Gorbacheva lands a quadruple salto like a feather in a cascade with a double axel and also airily twists another four-turn salto. She has no problems with the following jumps either. However, she made an unnecessary step out on the triple backstroke. It seems that she was surprised herself when she made this mistake. Sofia Fedchenko, the girl's coach, praised her student. "Well done," Fedchenko greeted Gorbacheva over the board. 155.16 points for Alina's free skating. Total score, 228.85 points. Sofia Akatieva begins the race with a stunning cascade of triple axel, triple toe loop. She also indispensably does a quadruple toe loop in a cascade with a double axel. The magic continued as she advanced to a solo triple axel. Sonia nearly fell off her solo quadruple toe loop and miraculously held on, making a grave error. Nevertheless, she had a very strong roll. Just think, four Ultra C elements, three of them clean. Sonia gets a huge 164.69 points from the judges for the roll. The total sum, 241.09 points. Sofia Muravyova jumped the solo triple axel cleanly, and apparently decided not to risk going for the second. Sonia, of course, overcorrected a lot. She made up for not doing a second triple axel by doing all the stunts in the second half. The story of Romeo and Juliet was told with constant artistry and grace. Yevgeny Plushenko praised after the roll. Sonia gets 155.10 points from the judges. Total score, 233.04 points. Kamila Valieva and her free skating for the Olympics. Two flawless quadruple toes, one of which is in a cascade with a double axel. Kamila fell off the triple loop which should have been a cascade with a triple toe loop. A serious loss, alas. It's a shame that this fall happened. Kamila skated so magnificently, so much emotion was invested and changed the ending again. She raised her hands to the sky in a dramatic gesture. Kamila lost to Akatieva in free skating, scoring 162.79 points. But she was ahead of the total, 241.76 points. Elizaveta Tuktamysheva perfectly landed a triple axel in a cascade with a double axel, but she blurred her departure from the solo trixel. No one has been able to skate cleanly on the Ultra C. Lisa conquered the rest of the jumps completely, but she did one of the spins only for the second level. Loneliness is probably one of the best productions of the season, and Lisa is divine in it. The stands thanked the skater very loudly for her skating. Lisa gets 160.52 points for her free skating. Total score of 241.61 points. Fourth flip from Adelia Petrosyan. Opening night. With a cool head, the girl also did a quadruple toe loop in a cascade with a double axel. But she fell on her solo quadruple toe and avoided the fall. Adelia unexpectedly went for a triple axel, but fell. The complexity of the girl's content is astounding. It is clear that today she did not manage to do all the ultras, but keep in mind this athlete, she is improving incredibly fast. Adelia is happy, she won the Grand Prix Finals. 169.39 points for the free skating event and 255.01 points, a staggering result. Tatiana Tarasova said she was ready to support any coach in case of unfair refereeing. The day before, Tarasova said that Channel 1 suspended her for supporting Yevgeny Plushchenko's statements about refereeing. "If it wasn't Plushchenko, but another person, it wouldn't matter to me. It's just unfair judging. If it had been someone else, I would have performed the same way. I respect the work of the coaches and, most importantly, the work of the athletes, the young athletes," Tarasova said. Elena Vaitskalskaya is surprised that Tatiana Tarasova criticizes the judging in figure skating. "There has always been bias on the part of the referees in figure skating. It is originally part of the unwritten rules of the sport, and, I suppose, it will always be so as long as there are living people with their tastes and preferences sitting behind the desks. Which is why I was a little surprised to hear Tarasova complain about the judging. She knows better than anyone how the world works. She was, which is no secret to anyone, hated by the Federation, and consequently not liked by the judges who were there at the time. I think that that was partly the reason why in her coaching golden years Tarasova taught all her students, you have to be two heads above your opponents in order not to depend on the arbitrariness of the judges. And it worked. In fact, at the junior finals in St. Petersburg, Veronika Vilina won the competition by this very principle, even though she had damaged the first of the four jumps in her free skating program. I have already written, but I will repeat, if an athlete makes a mistake, then complaining about the judging is not the right strategy. I also don't think that screwed or not screwed statements are appropriate here. First, each judge looks at the ice from a slightly different perspective, so even those who work on the same team may have different opinions. Secondly, any, even the tiniest, doubts about an element can be interpreted as positive or negative. This, too, is inherently subjective. Yes, it can be very, very frustrating, but those are the rules of the game, and again, someone with enormous experience cannot be unaware of them. It's possible that Tarasova's reaction in support of Plushchenko was emotionally driven. Over the last few years, Yevgeny has become such a powerful figure in Russian single skating, especially in its junior segment, that it deserves at least encouragement and not a draconian approach from the officials. But it's a matter of luck. That said, not a single argument has been made on the coach's part that could realistically be taken into account. She thinks the refs are wrong, and they disagree. A normal working situation, of which there are many in figure skating. So they ended up with another scandal, which, to all appearances, Channel 1 just didn't think it was necessary to broadcast. Why should this be surprising? The journalist wrote in her TV channel, Dmitry Gubernyev spoke out about Tatiana Tarasova being suspended from commentary. Girls, here's the deal. It turns out that Channel 1 had no intention of inviting Tat to comment on the upcoming figure skating events. There's just a planned rotation of commentators. That's how it is. Sources at Channel 1 say. And Tatiana Tarasova will be brightly commentating on the show programs. All in all, everything should be fine, wrote the commentator.